Hello everyone. So in our previous video, we talked about the universal indicators and pH levels and how the pH level depends on various factors. What is the pH level of acids or bases? So in today's video, we will discuss the importance of pH in our everyday life. So how does pH affects our everyday life, or what is its role in our everyday life? That is the topic of today's video. So as you all know that the pH lower than 7 is known as acidic pH. The pH higher than 7 is known as basic pH. The pH 7 represents neutral compounds such as water or some salts. So now is the time for discussing the importance of pH in our everyday life. So basically, pH plays a very important role, as mostly we are going to learn about 5 new topics here, or 5 topics under this category, which is pH in digestion, the role of pH in digestion, and the role of pH in tooth decay, role of pH in crop production, pH for the survival of aquatic life at chemical warfare. So let's start from the first topic, which is role of pH in tooth decay. So as you all know that whenever we intake food, the food mixes with our saliva and forms a thin film on our teeth, which is known as plaque. So what this plaque does, that it prevents the saliva to reach our teeth, and what happens, there are various bacteria in our mouth which break down the sugary substances into acids, and these acids damage the enamel. Enamel is the outermost covering of teeth, which is slightly yellow in color, which you are able to see. So that enamel is a very hard substance, but when acid is formed between our teeth due to action of bacteria on sugary substances, that acid starts to accumulate because of plaque and corrodes the enamel layer. And when the corrosion of enamel layer happens, it causes cavity in our teeth. So there is a depression, or there is a slight hole may be formed in your teeth, and those depressions or slight holes are known as cavity. So cavities, like, they are formed because of the damage of the teeth. So to prevent the situation, to prevent any cavity from happening in your teeth, the teeth should be brushed twice a day to prevent cavities. How does this work? That when you brush twice a day, the acid which is getting formed in your mouth due to the action of bacteria, that will be neutralized due to the action of your toothpaste. So your teeth would be safe from cavities. The second topic which we are going to study is pH of soil and how this affects the crop production. So the pH of the soil is very important for the growth of plant. The pH of soil should remain neutral, because most of the crops grow very well in neutral pH. But what happens if the farmer is using too much chemical fertilizer? So that uses of too much fertilizer, too much chemicals in your field may make the soil acidic, and the pH of soil may get reduced. So how the acidic soil gets cured? To cure the acidic soil, the best remedy is to add slaked lime in the field. Whatever your field is, wherever you are going to sow the crops, if you add slaked lime, which is also known as calcium hydroxide with the formula CaOH twice, the slaked lime neutralizes the acid formed in the field soil, and thus the pH of soil is balanced. What happens sometimes, the pH of soil becomes too basic because of various factors. If the soil pH becomes basic, in that case, in that scenario, you may add manure, organic manures or compost to it. So manures, what do they do? That manures are acidic in nature, they are slightly acidic, and if you add it in basic soil, it will neutralize the base formed in the soil, and the pH level of the soil will be restored. So this is the role of pH in crop production in case of soil. Next is the pH for survival of aquatic life. So as we all know that every organism needs a particular type of environment for their survival. If there is any change in the environment, the organism will face difficulties in surviving. So for aquatic life, we can say the same. Aquatic lives, their body is adapted to a particular pH level, like in case of ponds or in case of rivers or lakes. In case of freshwater resources, the aquatic life is adapted to a neutral pH. The animals or plants, whichever live in water, they are adapted to a neutral pH level. So whenever, because of acid rain or pollution, the water becomes acidic, the aquatic life is damaged. That is because of the pH level. Whenever there is an acid rain, it reduces the pH level of the pond or lake. And because of that reduced pH, the aquatic life faces difficulty in surviving. And because of that, they start to die. So the pH, a particular pH, is very necessary for the survival of aquatic life. Next, we were talking about the pH in. So earlier we were talking about the role of pH in digestion. So if you have learned in biology about the digestive system, you must be knowing that the different parts of our digestive system work on a different pH level. That means every part of our body needs a particular pH level for a proper function. If there is any disturbance in that particular pH level, the functions of our body will get disturbed, and our body will not be able to function our daily life functions very well. So in case of digestion, what can we say? That the pH of our stomach lies between 1 to 3, because of the release of HCl from the stomach. You must have learned that our stomach releases HCl to facilitate the digestion of protein. So that hydrochloric acid, which is released in stomach, helps in protein digestion. And because of the release of that hydrochloric acid from our stomach, the pH of our stomach lies between 1 to 3. So what happens that sometimes when we eat too much oily food or spicy food, or when we do not get timely meals, in that case also, the stomach starts to produce a lot of HCl. That means more than what is normal. So when stomach starts producing too much HCl, then that condition is called acidity. So it is very unpleasant, as you may feel a burning sensation in your stomach or in your chest, and you may feel difficulty in digestion also. So the condition of acidity may be cured very easily by the help of any antacid. Antacids are those substances which neutralize the effect of an acid, and And antacid can be any mild base which is fit for oral consumption. So whatever mild base which is fit for oral consumption is at hand, you can use that mild base as an antacid for the relief in acidity. So for relief in acidity, many kind of antacids are taken. One such example of an antacid is milk of magnesia. Milk of magnesia is a mild base with a formula MgOH twice. The chemical name of milk of magnesia is magnesium hydroxide. So magnesium hydroxide is a very mild base and its suspension in water is taken as an antacid for the relief in acidity. So now the last topic, the last topic of today is use of pH in chemical warfare. So there are many plants and animals which use acidic or basic substances in their defense mechanism. Defense mechanism means to protect themselves from predators or from any kind of hunters or predators or any kind of harms. So many plants and animals have their inbuilt mechanism and they have some acidic or alkaline substance which enable them to defend themselves against any kind of predator or any kind of such situations in which they may die. So one such example is honeybee and ant sting. So red ants and honeybee, they possess methanoic acid, which is also known as formic acid, in their sting. So whenever you get stung by a honeybee or an ant, you may apply a mild base on the affected area. What happens is that the mild base neutralizes the action of this methanoic acid and it provides instant relief. So wherever an ant or honeybee stings, you must have observed that the place gets irritated, there is redness and swelling. All of this is because of this methanoic acid which they have stung in your, which they have injected in your skin epidermis layer. And to neutralize this, you can use any mild base, like you may apply a baking soda solution there. Many people also apply quicklime or calcium hydroxide there, so which provides instant relief in that scenario. There is also a plant species which is known as nettles. So nettles is a native of America. It is found in American continent. So nettle plants have very thin, fine hair-like structure on their on the surface of their leaves. And these leaves are when in contact, these leaves when come in contact with our skin, with anyone's skin, they inject methanoic acid in the skin, which causes redness and irritation. So nettle plants also contains the same acid, methanoic acid, and wherever nettle plants are found, there is another plant called dock plant. So dock plant is another plant which is also found in the same region. So if you suffer from nettle stings, you just have to find a dock plant and apply the extracts of dock plant leaves, because dock plant leaves extracts are alkaline in nature. So if you are struck by nettle leaves, you may use dock plant extract to get instant relief from it. So it is an example of when nature gives you anything to suffer, it gives you the remedy also. Another example of such a defense mechanism is in wasps. So wasps have an alkaline liquid present in their sting. Whenever a wasp stings someone, it injects an alkaline liquid in the skin, which causes burning and irritation. So if the sting is done by any wasp, in that case, to cure that stung area, you may apply any mild acidic solution there. As you may have seen that during summer season, many wasps like they sting at your skin and you may see irritation and burning there. And the doctors provide a fudic acid ointment in that scenario. So that fudic acid ointment, what does it do? That wherever the wasp has stung, it neutralizes the alkaline solution or alkaline fluid whichever is injected in your skin, and thus it cures the stung area. So this is the video of today. I hope you understood all the topics carefully, and an assignment will follow shortly based on today's video. Thank you so much.